I want to talk to you a little bit about the bias in the media. There was a poll taken some years back, and a lot of members in the media were very unhappy about this, showing that among Washington, D.C. reporters, 89% of them voted for Bill Clinton. 7% voted for his Republican opponent. Now, those kinds of studies have been duplicated across the country. In my book, I have a chapter in the media bias, and I have in the index several polls going back to 1960 showing very similar results. Now, if reporters are human beings, and I think they are, it's awfully difficult for you to exclude your bias. And the bias shows up in all sorts of ways. There was an article in the LA Times a few years ago about House Majority Leader Dick Armey. The writer referred to Dick Armey as a hard-line conservative. I thought that was an interesting expression, so I had my producer check and find out how often the LA Times used the term in the last several years, hard-line conservative. And the answer was approximately 77 times. I then asked him to look over the same period of time and find out how often the LA Times used the expression hard-line liberal. Must be a hard-line liberal if there's a hard-line conservative. I would think Ted Kennedy or Maxine Waters or Tom Hayden, people like that, ought to be hard-line conservatives. Well, over the same period of time, the LA Times used the expression hard-line conservative twice.
Liberal.
Pardon me, hard-line liberal. You want to write my speech? Over the same period of time, the LA Times used the expression hard-line liberal twice. Once referring to Mikhail Gorbachev. Peter Jennings, January 22, 1993, one of Bill Clinton's first days in office. Quote, President Clinton keeps his word on abortion rights. President Clinton kept a promise today on the 20th anniversary of the Supreme Court decision legalizing abortion. Mr. Clinton signed presidential memoranda rolling back many of the restrictions imposed by his predecessors. Same day, Tom Brokaw. Today, President Clinton kept the campaign promise, and it came on the 20th anniversary of Roe v. Wade legalizing abortion. Dan Rather, same day. On the anniversary of Roe versus Wade, President Clinton fulfills a promise supporting abortion rights. That was 20 years ago today. The United States Supreme Court handed down its landmark abortion rights ruling, and the controversy hasn't stopped since. Today, with a stroke of a pen, President Clinton delivered on his campaign promise to cancel several anti-abortion regulations of the Reagan-Bush years. Okay? George W. Bush, one of his first days in office, reversed the Clinton policy and cut off federal funds that go to international organizations that counsel abortion. Jennings, quote, one of the president's first actions was designed to appeal to anti-abortion conservatives. The president signed an order reinstating a Reagan-era policy that prohibited federal funding of family planning groups that provided abortion counseling services overseas. Designed to appeal to anti-abortion conservatives. Dan Rather, this was President Bush's first day at the office, and he did something to quickly please the right flank of his party. He reinstituted an anti-abortion policy. Brokaw, we'll begin with the new president's very active day, which started on a controversial note. So when Bill Clinton rolled back the anti-abortion policies of his predecessor, he was keeping a campaign promise. When George Bush rolls back the pro-abortion policies of his predecessor, he is appeasing to his right flank. That, ladies and gentlemen, is bias. And it's subtle, but it influences you. You're sitting at home, you're watching this, and you are subtly being influenced. The papers the other day described the replacement of the chairman of the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission. His name is Hebert, a free market guy, does not believe in price controls. Article in the newspaper described him as a free market apostle. His replacement, however, was described as a pragmatist. You see the difference. Apostle, somebody who believes on faith, somebody who follows based on a feeling. No data, no studies. Not like 4,000 years of recorded human history has demonstrated that price controls don't work. No, he's a true believer. He's an apostle.
Jefe, what is a plethora?